This video is on the topic of the formation of ions. Let's start by explaining what we mean by the term ion. An ion is an electrically charged atom or group of atoms. Ions are formed when an atom or group of atoms loses or gains electrons. Ions can be negatively charged or positively charged, and the sizes of these charges can differ. You can see this by the different ions shown here. Be careful, some students get confused and think that positive ions are formed by the gain of positively charged protons. But it is really important that you know that ions can only be formed by the loss or gain of electrons. The definition of the term ion is worth learning, as this is an easy mark to pick up in an exam. To explain why ions are formed, we need to consider the electronic configurations of atoms. Most atoms, including sodium and chlorine shown here, have an incomplete outer shell of electrons. This arrangement of electrons is not very stable. A full outer shell of electrons is a much more stable arrangement. To achieve this stable arrangement, atoms lose or gain electrons, and we can see the electronic configurations of the sodium and chloride ion here, showing that they have a full outer shell. Remember that the noble gases, such as neon and argon, have full outer shells of electrons. So we can see that ions have the electronic configuration of a noble gas. Let's look at how ions are formed in more detail, starting with the formation of positive ions. Metal atoms typically have 1, 2, or 3 electrons in their outer shell, which they lose to form positive ions. Let's take sodium as an example. We can see that an atom of sodium has 1 electron in its outer shell. It has 11 protons and 11 electrons, so is electrically neutral. Its outer shell is incomplete, as it has space for another 7 electrons. To obtain a stable full outer shell of electrons, it can either lose this outer electron or gain 7 more electrons to fill the third shell. It actually requires less energy to lose an electron than to gain 7 more electrons, so sodium loses its outer electron to form a sodium ion. As you can see, the sodium ion has no third shell, but a full second shell. It still has 11 protons, but now it only has 10 electrons, so it has 1 more proton than electrons, and therefore it will have a charge of 1+. We show the charge by putting square brackets around the ion. This indicates that the charge is spread evenly across the ion, and the charge is just outside the bracket in the top right-hand corner. When other metal ions are formed, the size of the charge depends on how many electrons the metal atom has lost, and we can use the group number of the metal to help us determine the charge. Group 1 elements lose 1 electron, so form an ion with a 1+ charge. Group 2 elements, such as magnesium, lose 2 electrons, so form an ion with a 2+ charge, and so on. Non-metal atoms gain electrons to form negative ions. Again, we will look at an example to explain this in more detail. Let's take chlorine as an example. An atom of chlorine has 17 protons and 17 electrons, so it has no overall charge. Chlorine is in group 7, so it has 7 electrons in its outer shell, which means it has space for 1 more electron. Less energy is required to gain an extra electron than would be needed to lose all of its 7 outer electrons, so chlorine gains an electron to form a stable full outer shell. Now it has 18 electrons and 17 protons, giving it 1 more electron than protons. So it forms a chloride ion with a 1- charge. If you are asked to draw an ion, it is really important that you remember to put the square brackets around the ion and show the correct charge in the top right-hand corner. Otherwise, you will lose marks in an exam. Just like with positive ions, the size of the charge can be determined by the group number. Group 7 elements gain 1 electron to form ions with a 1- charge. Group 6 elements, such as oxygen, gain 2 electrons to form ions with a 2- charge, and so on. A way to remember this is that for negative ions, the group number plus the charge adds up to 8. For example, the group number of oxygen is 6, the charge on its ion is 2-, and 6 plus 2 is equal to 8. It is useful to remember that you can use the periodic table given to you in an exam to work out the charge an ion will have. There are a couple of terms that you need to know in relation to ions. We refer to positive ions as cations. For example, the aluminium 3+ ion and sodium 1+ ions shown here. Negative ions are known as anions, and the oxide ion and chloride ions are examples of anions. Students often find it difficult to remember which term belongs to which ion. But an easy way to remember this is that the word anion stands for a negative ion. As long as you can remember the meaning of one of these terms, you can work out the other name, and it saves you having to remember both. In summary, ions are electrically charged atoms or groups of atoms, which are formed by the loss or gain of electrons. Ions lose or gain electrons to gain a full outer shell of electrons, which is a much more stable arrangement. As they have a complete outer shell of electrons, their electronic configuration will be the same as of a noble gas. Metal atoms lose electrons to form positive ions, and non-metal atoms gain electrons to form negative ions. The terms cation and anion are used to describe positive ions and negative ions. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.